Some of the greatest minds from Western history had, well, interesting explanations for the workings of the reproductive system. Aristotle argued that the fetus was contained in male semen, while the female merely supplied the location and the nutrition for the fetus. Hippocrates noted that a woman's uterus can raise up into her throat and cause hysteria. Leeuwenhoek explained that semen contains parasitic animals called sperm, which was clearly more accurate than the explanation from most of the experts of the time who claimed that tiny men were curled up inside of male sperm. Two important things can be learned from this. First, for much of human history, the connection between sex and reproduction was unclear. Clearly, people knew that sex could result in offspring, but the mechanisms were not known. Second, these men were clearly very lonely. Today, scientists understand more of these mechanisms. In this module, you will learn how the human species perpetuates itself through reproduction. More specifically, we will examine structure and function of male and female reproductive organs, the process of reproduction from copulation and fertilization through fetal growth to parturition and lactation, including hormonal regulation. Along the way, you will discover that the reproductive system is a complex system that is aimed at survival of the species, not survival of the individual. And hence, this organ system is not aimed at homeostasis. With that being said, the health of the reproductive system depends on other organ systems and on their ability to maintain homeostasis. And remember, birds do it, bees do it, and yes, your grandparents did it. So if you need a refresher on birds and the bees, this module is for you.